Hello everyone, so welcome to today's video. So far we have talked about the various agents by describing their behavior and the action that it is performed after any given sequence of percepts. In today's video we will have to talk about how the basic internal things work. Okay, the primary job of AI is to design an agent program or design a rational agent, okay, which will implement the agent function that would map the percept sequences or perceptions to the actions. And we assume that this program will run on some sort of computing device with physical sensors and actuators, and this physical system is known as the, or computer system is known as the architecture. So let us get started, right? So talking about agent, if we are considering an agent, so agent basically comprises of the entire architecture in which a particular program would be running, or an agent program would be running. Now this agent program essentially is used to implement an agent function. Okay, so what is the role of this agent function? The role of the agent function is to map the percept sequence to some actions. Alright, so this is basically the primary goal of AI. So using AI we have to design this particular agent program which would run on certain architecture, and it will enable us to do certain action, or it will enable the computing system to do certain action. Obviously, the program which we have to choose has to be one which is appropriate for the architecture. We simply cannot randomly go ahead with choosing any particular program we feel like. Okay, so this, how does this agent program looks? Let me write it here as agent so that it becomes relatable to my previous video. So how does this agent program look, and what are the things which are associated with this agent program? We will all see this one by one. Okay, so talking about an agent program, we have to first identify which are the things which are necessary in a particular program. Okay, so let me give you a look of the agent program. Okay, so how does it look like? So first of all, let us identify the different things that it is associated, okay, or that is associated with the agent program. First of all, we have to implement a function, right? Function which will map the perceptions or percept sequences to actions. So please remember this point, that this has to be there throughout. Okay, and we have to understand that in the agent program the current percept is used as an input, whereas in agent function it takes the entire percept history. Okay, so this function will be taking the entire percept history, whereas in program, the agent program which is used to implement the function, that would be comprising of just the current input. Okay, so let us see how it looks like. So we have a function, let's name it as agent. Okay, and this will take the current percept as input, and it returns an action. So I'm writing down the pseudocode for this agent program. Okay, and we will simultaneously discuss what are the things associated. So I have a function here which is known as agent, and it is taking input as the percept and returns an action. Okay, input as the percept, because as already mentioned, agent program will take only the current percept as input. Okay, now we have the other parameters associated with it, which are basically percepts, and percepts are nothing but a sequence, and initially this sequence is empty, because right at the start of an agent, when it is not performing or not perceiving anything, so initially that percept, the sequence has to be empty, right? Then we have a table, right? So this is an agent. This agent program is basically a table-driven agent. So what do you mean by this is basically all the actions are stored in a tabular format, like we saw in the vacuum cleaner world. So similar concept is here as well. So table, which is a table of actions, basically which is a table of actions, and this table of action is actions are indexed by percept sequences. Okay, so different types of percept history would be used. I mean, the percept history would be used as per their sequences, and it would be represented in that manner. Okay, and initially it is fully specified. Initially fully specified, it means that we have already created that table and made that indexing based on the actions, like so and so action will happen if this percept sequence is or if this perception is there, right? So suppose in my vacuum cleaner world, if I consider, so if the room is empty, then the next action would be, if the room is clean, then the next the action associated would be move right. Okay, then, or if the room is dirty, it will suck up the dirt. So that percept sequence would be indexing the actions which my vacuum cleaner need to do, okay, which the agent needs to do. So essentially percepts and table, these two are the static components that we have. This will be there throughout the agent lifetime. Okay, now what will happen is there are dynamic things happening. Okay, dynamic things happening means we have to append, and what will we append or what will we add, what will we go on adding new to it? We will be going on appending the percept, that means current percept, to the end of percepts. So what was percepts? Percepts was nothing but the sequence. Okay, so in that sequence, let me show it with a different color. So this sequence is basically added with the current percept. Okay, we'll go on adding, right? And so once it is added, so what should be the next step? The next step would be to specify the action. And how will the action take place? The action will take place based on the lookup of the table and the percepts. Okay, so here we already have a table, that is the table of actions and the perceptions, which the current perception as well as the history of perceptions that we already have stored in percepts. So that particular, these two parameters will be checked before an action is finally performed. Okay, and the last step would be to return the action, right? So the last one we have to return, what we have to return is an action. So I think this we have already understood well, that it will be having some percepts. Okay, the agent will have certain input as percept, and this percept would be added to the percepts list which is already there in the agent. Okay, initially this percept sequence or percept list is empty. All right, next we have a table. This table is basically a table of actions, and it is indexed by the percept sequences. Okay, so whatever is the percept, based on that we have certain actions, and those things are stored in a tabular format. And after that we will be going on appending percept. This percept is basically the input which the agent will be perceiving. Okay, and it will be getting appended to the end of the already existing table. Okay, and after that, finally, how will the action be decided? The action will be decided on a lookup based on the static values, which are the percepts and the table. Okay, from here we will get the connections and get the values, and that will finally return me a action which the agent needs to perform. I think this much all of us are clear about. So we will move ahead with the next concrete topic of this agent programs or agents or the structure of agents, and we will be discussing what are the different types of agents program. Okay, so different types of agent programs available to us. So agent program types, right? So what are the different types of agent program which we have? All right, so in total we have four basic kinds of agent program which embodies the principle underlying almost all intelligent system, right? So the first one is the simple reflex agent. Simple reflex agent. The second one is a model based reflex agent. So if you see any type of agent, you can primarily categorize them into these four basic types of agent programs. Okay, and then we have goal based agents, which are one of the very very commonly used agents, because one of the primary aim of AI is to maximize the profit. Okay, so goal based and utility based agents are very very commonly used agents. Okay, utility based agents. So these we will see them one by one. So the first one that we have to discuss is a simple reflex agent. Okay, simple reflex agent. So if we look at it from a diagram point of view, this will look similar to how a rational agent how in the very beginning of our chapter we looked at this rational agents, right? Or how agents interact with environments, right? So it will look similar to that, but however there are certain things which are added. Okay, so first of all we have to draw the environment. So let's say this block represents the environment. Environment can be any task environment that the agent is in, all right? And then we have the agent block somewhere here. Okay, so in my agent block, first of all let me name it as agent. Okay, so first of all what does an agent do? It will perceive or it will sense the environment or get a perception of the environment and then it acts, right? So first of all, with the help of sensors, the agent will be perceiving the environment and it will draw a conclusion as to what the world is like now. So based on the sensors there will be a certain perception generated about the environment. Once the perception is received or once it has perceived, okay, the next step would be what actions I should do now. So this is the next possible step that the agent would be thinking about. Okay, and this particular step would be supported by condition action rules. This is just a table that I am talking about. Okay, so condition action rules. So it will have, based on the percept sequence, it will be having different actions indexed on the table, and that will serve as an input to this particular step. Okay, so this arrow however is not needed here. So then after it has decided on what action it should do now, it will make use of the actuators to do certain actions back to the environment. Alright, so this is the entire look of a simple reflex agent. And once again, talking about these agents, they select actions on the basis of the current percept. So whatever action it is given, it is basically designed, write it down, okay. So it is basically designed using the current percept. Okay, it will get a current percept, ignoring the rest of the percept history. Okay. So now we have to understand that this is one of the very, very typical and an ideal environment-based reflex agent, where we have certain condition action rules based on which I can take my decision. Okay, but always this particular situation is not possible, right? So we have to improvise on this method or improvise on this reflex agent so that much more utility or much more usability of an agent could be done. Okay, now suppose talking about a reflex agent, now imagine yourself as the driver of an automated taxi. Now if the car in front brakes and its brake lights come out, then you should notice this and initiate the braking, right? So in other words, some processing is done on the visual input to establish the condition, which we call that the car in front is braking, right? So there are, suppose let's say car A is there and car B is there, right? So if you see the lights on and you saw that it is applying brakes, then only you will be applying brakes, okay? Otherwise you will go on with the car, right? So this will be a condition action rule. All right, so if the car in front is braking, then you can initiate the braking of your own car, or you can apply brakes of your own car, right? So these are certain condition action rules which are available to the reflex agent, but however they do not support much as in context to the percept history. Okay, so if you make use of your complete percept history, there would be some other output. Okay, suppose let me consider that I am not using this condition action rule and I want to use a percept history based action. Okay, so if I'm considering a percept history based action, then what would happen that I would also consider the perception related to the width of the road. Let's say this is the road, okay? So car A is somewhere here, your car is somewhere here. So even if this car apply brakes, you can simply take a turn and go ahead, isn't it, without applying the brakes. So it will not be your travel or your speed will not be compromised, right? So you will be able to travel at the same speed as what you were already traveling, right? But because there was a condition action rule that if car in front applies brake, then car behind also should apply brake, that is why you have to apply the brakes, which means that simply having a set of condition action rules will not satisfy, though it is also a tabular form or of perception, but based on this condition action rule, simply taking action will not be maximizing my profit. Okay, instead if I use a percept history, okay, a table based on perception sequences, then it would give me much, much more intelligent action and thereby maximize my objective. Okay, so simple reflex agent is hence it works fine but in ideal conditions. Okay, so based on this, there were various modifications to the simple reflex agent, and one such reflex modification is the model based reflex agent. Okay, so let us talk about the next one, which is the model based reflex agent, right? So model based reflex agent is mostly used to handle the partial observability. Okay, so if the environment is not fully observable and it is just partially observable,
then your model based reflex agent is an ideal agent. Okay, it should, and the agent also should maintain some sort of internal state that depends on the percept history and thereby reflects at least some of the unobserved aspects of the current state. So in my previous example, the problem we discussed about the car, that means if my car was behind, let's say here, this scenario I'm talking about. So if my car was behind and the road was wide enough, then also it could have maintained the same speed and it would have been able to drive in the same speed, right? Now if this was because, but we did not go for it, we simply applied the condition action rules without fully observing the situation, isn't it? So in this model based, what happens is that we will maintain some sort of internal state. Okay, let me call it as an internal state. So we'll maintain some sort of an internal state, and this particular internal state would be dependent upon the percept history. So once we associate the percept history, that means even if the environment was not fully observable, still decisions could be made based on some unobserved aspects of the current state, right? Now when we are talking about a model based agent, okay, we understood that we have to update the internal state information as time goes by, and it requires two kinds of knowledge to be encoded in the agent program. So since this is a list, okay, this is basically a percept sequence, and this sequence needs to be updated at every moment or every point of time, and it requires two different knowledge. Okay, there should be two different knowledge which should be encoded in the agent program. First of all, we need some information about how the world evolves independently of the agent. Okay, so how the world evolves independently, I'll write it down, world evolves independently without the agent. Okay, sorry, the spelling is wrong. Independently without, or not without, of, independently of the agent. That means without the agent, how does the world evolve? What are the changes made to the world? Suppose that road, how wide that road is? Is there possibility of extending further? How many cars are driving through that road? So without the presence of the agent in that particular world, okay, how does it behave? All right. Or let's say an overtaking car generally will be closer behind than it was a moment ago. So all these things has to be considered, right? Without the in the absence of the agent, how the world would evolve? Or in fact, if the agent is present in the environment also, without the agent performing any action, how will the world evolve? Okay, and the second is that we need some information about how the agent's own actions would affect the world. Okay, so what actions, or not what actions, how will the agent's actions affect the world? Okay, what would be the effect of the agent, of the agent probe, agent's actions on the world? So this also needs to be incorporated in the agent. Okay, now suppose on that road I was talking about, car A was there and car B was there. Because it was, the distance was more, maybe the car would take overtake the first car. Okay, now there might be another car C here, and because of this, the B might not be able to overtake it, right? So all those things also needs to be incorporated, that if the B moves to right, whether there will be a a problem or it will go on smoothly. Okay, so these two knowledge has to be incorporated in the agent, okay, in order to maintain this internal state. Once this particular internal state is ready, then any new action could be immediately incorporated inside this particular model based reflex agent. So these two becomes these two knowledge, let me number it, number one and number two. So 1 + 2 would actually be generating a model based on which the agent will be able to take the correct decision and perform the correct action using their actuators. Okay, so let us see how a model based reflex agent look like. Okay, so diagrammatically let us draw the environment again. Environment, see, environment for makes a very very important, this particular block marks a very important component, because whatever action is going to take place, that should always be in a, let me draw it properly, that will always be in the form of a the action will always be on the environment. Okay, so this environment is here. Okay, so let me just draw this. And from the environment, the sensors would be able to sense the different perceptions or different inputs would be generated from this particular environment. Okay, so this is the agent. Again, it will look like a simple reflex agent, but with a lot of other components involved apart from only the condition action rules. Condition action rules will be there, no doubt, but there will be some other supporting parameters in order to remove the deficiencies of your simple reflex agent. So through sensors, it will be taking in the perception or perceiving the environment, and after that it will have the same steps at what, like the simple reflex agent, what the world is like now. Okay, so this will have the same block, and after that again it will have the next step, the same steps as that of a simple reflex agent. What action I should do now, right? And after that, once the action is decided with the help of actuators, it can simply act on the environment, right? So talking about this, and also we have the same block as condition action rules. Now what changes here? Okay, what are the changes here? First of all, we have to include two different knowledge, right? We already mentioned here how the world evolves and what would my actions do. Okay, so let us add these two knowledge here. Okay, how the world evolves and what my actions do. So these two would be incorporated in this particular step. Okay, because since after the sensors perceive some information from the environment, instead of drawing a conclusion based on only the perceptions, current perceptions, it will actually be also taking help from the knowledge of how the world evolves and what my actions do. My here refers to the agent's own actions, okay? And also it will be working on information which it gets from the current perception, and it will finally form a state, okay? So this state is the description of the current world state. All right, so this current world state essentially is a conclusion from point number from this step and this step. Okay, so 1, 2 and 3, all of them combine to give a final state of the world. Okay, and this state is actually stored in the percept sequence. Alright, so once we receive this, we can simply go ahead with the next course of action, which is to find out what action the agent should do now. And this actions would be supported by the condition action rules. Okay, though condition action rules are used here, but it is the agent is also making use of the other percept sequences based on its availability and non-availability. So this to some extent forms a model. This state basically refers to a model. Okay, so and one more thing I forgot to mention is how the world evolves. This is also based on certain existing or pre-existing theories about the world. Okay, so how the world evolves will essentially not involve only the independent evolution of the environment, but also will be also certain theories and already established model regarding the environment could be considered, right? And after everything is sorted through the actuators, it can work upon the environment again. So this is how a model based agent looks like. Model based agent, we'll call it as a reflex agent. Okay, model based reflex agent, because the reflex agent we are not changing, we are simply changing the way it is working. Okay, model based reflex agent. So this model based reflex agent has this particular working mechanism. Alright, we will also look at goal based agents and utility based agents, but in the next video. So up till now we have understood that in order to devise a agent program, what are the things involved, and we also saw that with a pseudocode. Okay, and we also saw how agent program looks like. After that we talked about the different agent different types of agent program, of which we discussed simple reflex agent and model based reflex agents. Okay, and we understood that simple reflex agent, they work with a fully deterministic environment, or it has to be a fully observable environment. Okay, we can actually it is already established and it has a very ideal working condition. However, for model based reflex agent, we definitely make use of some other parameters, other knowledge based information when it comes to its working. So we saw them from a diagrammatic point of view, and we came to a conclusion that model based reflex agents serve as a better perspective for partially observable environment as compared to a simple reflex agent. Okay, so that is all for today. We will again discuss on this further in our next video. Thank you.